case you all haven't figured this out yet, I'm Todd Bertrand. This is Duncan Keller. Now you know who I am. This is Todd with this beard, and this is Duncan with that beard. Got it now? This here is our 1939 last year Indian Hill Climber. They made 18 of these this year. This is number 8 of 18. These Hill Climbers with this Flathead model was only made in 38 and 39. That's it. They were so fast by 45 to where rumor is that they were banned from the AMA because they're too fast. Duncan just went over this fine machine for me. And she's ready to run, tightened up everything. The only thing we've got to redo, there's two little studs here at the bottom that have pulled loose, and this is pushed up a little bit. So we're gonna fix that later. We're gonna fire it up today and do a few burnouts out here in the grass. So she's ready to run, he's got the linkages all working good. I flipped this bike a year and a half ago and about killed myself. That's how fast this bike is. Gave it a little gas and dropped the clutch and about killed me. This is an original paint bike. I've run the spectrometer over it. It is real paint. This is a original Titol bike. It's the only hill climber known, at least an Indian, probably in any of them, with the original Titol. It is original paint. We have photos, day of sale. Every racer that raced this bike, Lauren Rusneck bought it new. Oakley was the second rider. Ken Winston was the third rider, went to a big collection. Jerry Chin got it, he had it for 25 or so years. I got it from Chin. Complete history is known on this bike. I can't even begin to impress upon you how strong this machine is. Duncan, who takes bikes to Bonneville and races them with a dyno, says, I'm impressed. That's how fast this bike is. So we're gonna fire it up right now. You wanna say any little words on this, Duncan?
Not a whole lot, but basically what I noticed when I fired this for the first time was that this thing, and you'll notice that once we warm it up and I wrap the throttle a few times, that this thing really, really, really is so crisp and grabs the RPM so quickly. Generally on a flathead engine, the sound a little lazy, and it's based on the combustion chamber design of the engine itself. And it impressed me. I haven't seen it go down in a straight line yet, but as far as the engine sounded, it sounded really, really awesome. Carburetor has got what's called a barrel carburetor. So it's got literally a barrel that turns this way. And during the full throttle, the barrel is totally open and there's no restriction through the bore. There's no butterfly in this carburetor. Because of that, there's also no choke. So starting procedure on this is you really put your hand over it, you really choke it a lot, get a lot of fuel up into the flathead motor, and then hopefully with good luck, it'll fire for us. But so we may kick a little bit to get this down, but it will fire off, and like I said, it sounds really impressive. So I think we should start and see if we can get going.
Let's go ahead
and retard it. Okay, she's set in retard.
Okay. Let's see what we can
full
do.
Full throttle, and let me choke it for you.
Okay. Couple more. Okay, right. She's got gas now. Takes a little bit, but she will fire up.
Give it about a quarter of a minute.
That's what I was saying about this rear stand. It's just likes to come off a little bit.
Mm-hmm. I'm going to choke a little bit more. Hit your kill button. Hold it. Hold the bottle. One more time. More yet.
Okay.
My turn.
Your turn. Let's move her up and get off our indent. Created.
Your turn. Check it. likes it a little bit of retard, but it's very touchy.
Very touchy.
It'll go.
Pretty wicked machine. It's just an amazing. This thing's still around in its original condition and runs. It's got a two-speed gearbox on it, and there's a big lever we'll show you on the left-hand side of the bike, and you push it down for one gear and pull up in for the other gear.
Is the vent fully on?
Oh, you know what? It may not be.
We're checking the advance spring.
10 seconds.
What I just did while you were watching was I leaned out the main jet some. It's got an adjustable main jet on the bottom of the carburetor. And then I also leaned out the low speed also. I can see now it's picking up RPM a lot better. Actually, for the barrel carburetor, it's actually quite sensitive. Look at that.
Yeah, look at that smile.
Not bad. That thing out and rotate your lawn.
Did I ride it?
Yeah.
Things happen in time. Oh, fire.
Now that's a little better, huh?
Yeah, now she runs like I remember. What a fun machine. What a fun machine.
Yeah, you're just doing nice little rooster tails out there.
Uh-huh.
You know, very, very nice.
Yeah, that's how she was running when I did my boo-boo.
Yeah. Yeah, I just leaned it out a little bit and,
yeah,
more efficient on that.
Okay.
Let's see, it should hopefully fire right back up again.
Yeah. There you go. That balls to ride that shit up the hill. Mud when I flipped it. That's how powerful that bike is, man. Like crazy.
Got good traction.
Mm-hmm.
Thank you. There you go, gentlemen. Riding a piece of history. That was fun. That's great fun.
Yeah.
I think I'm a little big for it, but it's still fun.
It's still fun. Oh, man. Okay. We'll see y'all next time when we whip out the next cool bike.
Have a good time. No restriction through the bore. There's no butterfly in this carburetor. Because of that, there's also no choke. So starting procedure on this is you really put your hand over it, you really choke it a lot, get a lot of fuel up into the flathead motor, and then hopefully with good luck, it'll fire for us. But so we may kick a little bit to get this down, but it will fire off, and like I said, it sounds really impressive. So I think we should start and see if we can get going. Okay,
let's
go ahead and retard it. Okay, she's set in retard.
Okay, let's see what we can do.
Full throttle, and let me choke it for you.
Okay, so we've got gas now. Takes a little bit, but she will fire up.
Give it about a quarter of a minute.
That's what I was saying about this rear stand. It's just likes to come off a little bit.
I'm going to choke a little bit more. Hit your kill button. Hold it. Pull the throttle. One more time. More yet.
More yet, eh? Mm-hmm.
Pull the throttle.
Okay. That's just pull the throttle.
Okay. Okay.
Okay.
My turn.
Your turn. Let's move her up and get off our indent. Created. Okay.
Your turn.
What I just did while you were watching was I leaned out the main jet some. It's got an adjustable main jet on the bottom of the carburetor. And then I also leaned out the low speed also. I can see now it's picking up RPM a lot better. Actually, for the barrel carburetor, it's actually quite sensitive. Look at that.
Yeah, look at that smile.
Not bad. Get that thing out and rototill your lawn. It's got a two-speed gearbox on it, and there's a big lever we'll show you on the left-hand side of the bike. And you push it down for one gear and pull up in for the other gear.
Is the vest fully on?
You know what? It may not be.
We're checking the vest spring.
A little bit of retard, but it's very touchy.
Very touchy.
It'll go. Okay, that's enough. Full advance.
That's a pretty wicked machine. It's just amazing that this thing's still around in its original condition and runs.
case you all haven't figured this out yet, I'm Todd Bertrang. This is Duncan Keller. Now you know who I am. This is Todd with this beard, and this is Duncan with that beard. Got it now? This here is our 1939, last year, Indian Hill Climber. They made 18 of these this year. This is number 8 of 18. These Hill Climbers with this Flathead model was only made in 38 and 39. That's it. They were so fast by 45, the weird rumor is, that they were banned from the AMA because they were too fast. Duncan just went over this fine machine for me. She's ready to run, tightened up everything. The only thing we've got to redo, there's two little studs here at the bottom that have pulled loose, and this is pushed up a little bit. So we're gonna fix that later. We're gonna fire it up today and do a few burnouts out here in the grass. So she's ready to run, he's got the linkages all working good. I flipped this bike a year and a half ago and about killed myself. That's how fast this bike is. Gave it a little gas and dropped the clutch and about killed me. This is an original paint bike. I've run the spectrometer over it. It is real paint. This is a original Titol bike. It's the only Hill Climber known, at least an Indian, probably in any of them, with the original Titol. It is original paint. We have photos, day of sale. Every racer that raced this bike, Lauren Rusnak bought it new. Oakley was the second rider. Ken Winston was the third rider, went to a big collection. Jerry Chin got it, he had it for 25 or so years. I got it from Chin. Complete history is known on this bike. I can't even begin to impress upon you how strong this machine is. Duncan, who takes bikes to Bonneville and races them with a dyno, says, I'm impressed. That's how fast this bike is. So we're gonna fire it up right now. You wanna say any little words on this, Duncan?
Not a whole lot, but basically what I noticed when I fired this for the first time was that this thing, and you'll notice that once we warm it up and I wrap the throttle a few times, that this thing really, really, really is so crisp and grabs the RPM so quickly. Generally on a flathead engine, they sound a little lazy, and it's based on the combustion chamber design of the engine itself. And it impressed me. I haven't seen it go down in a straight line yet, but as far as the engine sounded, it sounded really, really awesome. Carburetor has got what's called a barrel carburetor. So it's got literally a barrel that turns this way. And during the full throttle, the barrel is totally open and there's no